The beauty of this game is that by looking at what cards are available to everyone, you can anticipate what your opponents may have. In Texas Hold'em, luck plays a big part. However, a few players are always more successful. Are they just inherently lucky people? I believe there is far more to it. In poker, you can swing the odds in your favour. This is done by reading your own situation and that of your opponents, as well as understanding the odds of specific cards being dealt. If you play with discipline, putting yourself in good situations rather than bad ones, you are far more likely to win. So how does this play out in your career? I believe that the most successful people are indeed lucky, but they have also managed to swing the odds in their favour. There are two straightforward ways of doing this. Putting yourself in the right place, as I did at the Velodrome, and meeting the right people. Being visible is crucial to success. If people don't know who you are and what you are trying to achieve, they won't come along and offer you a leg up. If nobody knows you are branching out in a new direction, then opportunities won't come your way. There is already far too much noise out there. If your plan involves keeping your head down, you'll never stand out from the crowd. The first step is by dropping things into your daily conversations. By doing this, you are planting a seed. You'd be surprised how many useful connections can be made through the network you already have. Try it next time you get a phone call or meet up with someone. When they ask the inevitable, "Hey, how are you?" rather than your usual one-word answer, try a new approach. Maybe tell them what you're aiming to do. For me, it could be something like, "Hey Neil, how are you?" "Yeah, good thanks. I'm writing a book at the moment and I'm trying to work out how to go about publishing it." At this stage, if my friend has no interest, they will move the conversation on. However, perhaps they know someone who has written a book before, or know someone in the publishing industry. If they do, no doubt they will offer to connect me with that person. It's a simple adjustment to the way you communicate. Try it and see what opportunities come your way. We will be looking at the specifics of achieving your goals in the next section. This may give you a clearer picture of what you currently need help with. The next stage is to put yourself in rooms with people who can help you progress. This could be a specific person. If, for instance, you hope to get a promotion at work, then you need to be visible to the people who make those decisions. Hard work will get you so far, but why not swing the odds in your favour? If you are in a room with one of your seniors, strike up a conversation. Take the opportunity to ask what they are working on and if there is anything you can do to help.